speed and safety. It's always finding the right balance with AI. We're here today at MWC, at the EY booth, and I have two experts with me, Beatriz, Saiz, you're the global lead data and AI, and Jay Persaud, you're the global lead in emerging technology ecosystems. And we're going to discuss what is most important. Is it speed, or is it safety, or is it the balance? Jay, let's start with you. If we look to speed, you're working with emerging technologies and ecosystems. They're always pushing the boundaries to find the fastest solution. Can you explain how this works?
Yeah. Well, what we're seeing right now are many of these emerging companies, as you say, are taking advantage of an enormous opportunity to solve real business problems unique to industries. We're calling them vertical AI.
Yeah.
And they're moving quickly, and they're being very successful. There are hundreds of these companies that we're seeing right now. It's also important to keep in mind that as we solve for these issues, that we take the time to make sure that we put in controls. That's on all of us to do in some way. But there is an endless supply right now of ideas, of capital, of these organizations, and they're making real progress.
And how do they be sure that everything is still safe? Can you jump in? You're heading data and AI. Safety is the foundation, otherwise there's no AI.
Safety is absolutely critical. Mm-hmm. Think about, for example, an autonomous car, right? Where, you know, the response is not 100% safety. Or think about a co-pilot in the emergency room of a hospital making their triage. You really need to make sure. Now, this technology is still in research, so its nature is probabilistic. So basically, to the same question in the same context, not always the answer is still the same. Mm-hmm. But that's why all the regulation is there. But actually, it's a problem where I think the solution will come from the technology itself. There's a lot of investigation at the moment, and knowledge graph, the more context you bring into kind of these language models, the better the outcome, the lower the risk for hallucinations. Actually, we've been working in driving and launching a confidence index, which is running at an application level, which, you know, somehow it gives a solution to kind of that potential issue.
Yeah, and it's always what you put data in. If you feed it with the right data, the answers can go in the right direction, but if you feed it with the wrong data, it can go wrong. So how do you manage, both for the startups and the emerging technology, basically getting the right data in? Because I think you have a keynote later today where you make a statement, are we going to mirror the human's behavior or not?
Yeah, that's to me, like, I might be a bit controversial. I think even more important than data is the knowledge.
Yeah.
The knowledge that you put on top of the data, the context, the meaning somehow that you give to that data, that's what is essentially at the core. This thing about generative AI is a knowledge management issue rather than anything else. What do you think, Jay?
I couldn't agree more. I mean, you'll hear about the terms like fine-tuning, hallucinations. I mean, those are nice ways of saying that models make mistakes, because they are probabilistic, as Bea says. And I think it's really important to take the time to make sure that we tweak it so that it focuses over time, so that the probability of those errors continuing to occur go down. And that's what we're talking about when we refer to safety. So the faster you go, the more likely you are that you're going to accept a wider range of hallucinations. If you slow down, you can narrow that, and you'll get to an answer that we can all be more comfortable with over time, that what's going into the model is the thing that we expect to come out of it, or with its appropriate analysis, I should say. And so, Bea referred to the confidence index that we're doing at EY. That's the whole idea, right? That what you're getting out of it, management, users like the three of us here, we can feel comfortable that this thing is going to be appropriate for the purposes that we expect it for. And so, that's work, takes time, slow down a little bit.
Yeah, sometimes you have to slow down. Yeah. So Jay, Beatriz, thanks a lot. Thank you for watching from here, from the EY booth at Mobile World Congress 2024 in Barcelona.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.